Hello everyone. Welcome to the 27th video of the Adobe After Effects tutorial from beginner to advanced. If you want to learn the After Effects software completely, please subscribe to my channel. Markers are used to mark and save information on layers and composition at the desired time. For this tutorial, I prepared this project and pressed the space button to see the animation. Now I want to create a marker when the ball hits the table, so that for example I can add a sound to the animation later. Notice that I have not selected any layer now. The ball hits the table at frame 15, so I move the time pointer to frame 15 and hit the star button on the keyboard. Also, instead of pressing the star button, we can select the add marker option from the layer menu. In this way, a marker is created on the work area. Now I place the time marker at 1 second and 12 frames and hit the star button on the keyboard to create another marker when the ball hits the table. In order for the time indicator to be placed on each marker, we right-click on the desired marker and click on the Go to Marker Time option. In this way, the time indicator jumps on the markers. Also, by holding the Shift button on the keyboard, the time indicator snaps to the markers. To delete any marker, we can right-click on the desired marker and select Delete this marker, and to delete all markers, click on Delete all marker. I hit Ctrl plus Z a few times to go back. In order not to move the markers by mistake during the construction of a project, we can lock the markers. To do this, we select the Lock Markers option. In this way, we can no longer move the markers. If I right-click on one of the markers again and select Lock Markers, the markers will be unlocked. In some projects, instead of creating a marker at a specific time, it is necessary to set a time frame for the marker. For example, we can specify the entry and exit times of an object. To do this, we right-click on the desired marker and select the Enable Protected Region option. In this way, the keyframe is divided into two parts, and by moving the right part, we can change the value of the time interval, and by moving the left part, we can change the location of the time interval. To add a numbered marker at the desired time, press the Shift key plus a number key on the keyboard. I press the Shift key and the number 5 key on the keyboard. This will create a marker with the number 5. Now I right-click on one of the markers and select the Settings option. Also, to access the Settings section of each marker, you can double-click on the desired marker. In the Composition Marker window, the Time option shows the current time of the marker, and the Duration determines the time interval value. For example, I set the time interval of this marker to 10 frames. And now in the comments section, one can write down the explanation or information about this marker, so that in complex projects I can make the changes I wrote down at the right time. For example, I write down the word music so that later at this time I can add music or sound to the project. In the label section, we can change the color of the marker to distinguish it from other markers. I select the red color for this marker and hit OK. In this way, I created a red marker with a time interval of 10 frames, and the word music was created as an explanation next to this marker. Also, by selecting each layer and pressing the star key on the keyboard, instead of adding markers on the work area, we can create markers for each layer separately. Note that by right-clicking on any marker created on the layers bar, there are exactly the same options as I described. Finally, if you want to change the default color of the markers, select Preferences from the Edit menu and then Labels. Now choose the desired color from the comment section. I select the green color and press the OK button. In this way, every new marker will be green. Okay guys, thank you very much for watching this tutorial till the end. Please like the video and leave a comment for me. Subscribe to see more tutorials. I see you next time.